Hey everyone. In this video, I'm going to take you through how to connect up your HubSpot account with your Microsoft Teams account. So if you're using HubSpot and you're working with Microsoft Teams in your company, then this is the video for you. This one, I'm going to focus on the meeting scheduler so that when you're using the meeting scheduler to offer to your clients, so they can fill in this form like this and they can select the time to meet with you, then they'll also get the link to the Teams call so that it's already in their calendar so that you don't have to worry about sending them a reminder later on with the invitation information for the Teams so they can join the Teams video call. So it's very straightforward. I've already done a video for Zoom, so please check that out, connecting up HubSpot and Zoom. And I've also done a series of videos or a couple of videos about the meeting scheduler itself as well in HubSpot. So please take a look at those. All the links are in the description below as well. So today we're going to go through and look at this. You can see here I've created a few examples. The group, the round robin style meetings, you can see these options here. But we're going to look at the standard one-to-one, one-on-one email, one-on-one scheduling. And I've created this example here. If we go into this one, normally you would have this as sort of text only. Let me show you an example. So it just might be meeting or whatever, meeting room or meeting call or whatever, conference call. You know, this is text only, it won't change. We want to replace that with a link to our software, to our video conferencing platform. I've already added Zoom. As I said, you can check that out in the other video. But let's say you're not using Zoom and you want to use Microsoft Teams instead. Well, you'll need to add that as a connected app into HubSpot. So when it comes to Zoom and a few other extensions, you're able to add them directly in this screen. But for Teams, it's a larger app extension that you'll need to add separately, an integration, as it's called in HubSpot. So let's go into this link here. So if we're on this page, you want to go to Manage Extensions, or if you want to find it another way, you can go up to Settings, and then you can go to Integrations and Connected Apps, for example. So I guess you could say that this is called Extensions, this is called Integrations, this is called Connected Apps. It's all the same thing in HubSpot in this particular case. So those terms seem to all be used interchangeably. So as you can see here, we're missing Teams. We have no Teams, Microsoft Teams. So we need to add that separately. We're going to go to the App Marketplace, type in Teams. There's a lot of great apps here, so feel free to check that out as well. Maybe check it out separately. You might be using some of these tools already. It might be good to plug that into HubSpot. So we select Teams, and it's good to note that the Teams integration does more than just for the meeting scheduler. You can see here, it'll also send notifications through to your Teams app itself. You can add in Teams steps and workflows. You can do a lot of other little bits and pieces as well. So this is quite a useful integration. But today we're just going to talk about the meeting scheduler. So let's install this app. Click Install App. It depends on your particular company. And if you're the super admin and you're running your HubSpot account, and maybe you're also running other parts of your company's tech setup, you can decide what kind of install you want to do here. As you can see here, it explains it quite well. You can either do a full install or you could do a part install, depending on the structure of your company. I'm going to do the full install and click Install App. And then I just have to log into my account here. So I've just got this demo account, which I'm going to click on here. And there, once it's all connected up, it goes through, it says connected. And it's pretty straightforward. And then the app should appear here. Let me just do a quick refresh. There we go. And we've got our Microsoft Teams. And here we can control and look at all the settings. I won't go into the detail for this video because I want to keep it short, but you can explore that as well. Or maybe I'll do a video in the about this, and I'll share that as well when that's done. So let's go back to our meetings. Let's refresh this screen. And now, let's look here, and we can select Microsoft Teams. So then if I save this, let me do a quick demo of this as well. So you can see here, I've got these tokens here that will pull in automatically from the contact details when they fill in the form. Let's go back to the meeting page and we're going to open up this registration page. We've got our meet with Tristan. I really don't like that. I'm going to change that as well. So I'm going to change this. I go into this in the other video, but this is annoying me. So I'm going to change this now. Intro consulting. Cool. Okay. Like that, for example. And then if we go back to our meetings, we can see what that looks like. I'll close these windows here. So let's open that. Now you can see what I just changed. Let's create a time. Let's add in some new details here. Jamie, Len. I'm going to just add a 3 here just to create a new example. Confirm. And then we have our meeting booked. Okay, so this is what the user will see. The client or the contact, they'll receive this, they'll see this page. They'll then get an email and with all the details and the link, the Microsoft Teams link. So let's check that out. So here's the meeting. We can see here, this is the HubSpot notification. Let me display the images here. So we've got our HubSpot notification, booked meeting with Tristan, and the email address, the contact email address, and the location for that meeting. So we have our Teams link here. And then this is how it looks as well. They get a calendar invitation, their name, the rest of the name of the detail you've put in. This is all in this section here. We can see here, sorry, the event title and the details you've added into the rest of that here in the description. We can see all of that automatically comes through, and that this is how the customer, the client, the contact will receive the information in their inbox, and they can just, it's automatically, I think, confirmed here. They can click yes, and this is all there ready for their call when you have it coming up. So it's all automatically. So I strongly advise, this is a great tip, put it in under location, add your platform here so that everything is all in one place, ready to go, and the client knows how they joined the call as well. You might also want to mention that here as well. So let me know what you think. If that's been useful, make sure you check out my other videos around the meeting scheduler so you can understand the rest of the setup and all the other options here and get it all working really well for yourself. Let me know if this has been useful. If you have any questions, if there's any areas you want me to go into more detail or any other parts of HubSpot you want to learn more about, and I'd be happy to record some additional tutorials and other videos that hopefully can be useful for you in your HubSpot journey. So thank you so much, and look forward to seeing you in the next one. Have a great day. Cheers.